Let's assign bond order as shown on this slide. A single bond has a bond order of 1.0, a double bond an order of 2.0, and a triple bond an order of 3.0. Bond orders between these values reflect partial bond character. For instance, in the two resonance structures of benzene, we see that each pair of connected carbons has a single bond in one resonance structure and a double bond in the other. This holds equally well for any of the six carbon-carbon bonds. As a result, we would expect benzene's C-C bonds to have an order of 1.5. Using a graph of bond length as a function of order, we can interpolate and predict a C-C bond length of 1.42 angstroms. Here you can see that we've fixed the bond order at 1.5, and moving up the graph to the point where it intersects the line, we would predict a bond length of about 1.42 angstroms. This is only 0.02 angstroms away from the observed bond length of benzene, 1.40 angstroms, for an error of only 1.4%. By averaging the integral orders between two atoms in all of the resonance structures of a compound, we can compute a very accurate and predictive bond order. For instance, in the naphthalene shown, we would expect this bond to have a bond order of 1.67. We would expect this bond, on the other hand, to have a bond order of only 1.33, and as a result, based on the graph on the last slide, we would expect it to be a longer bond than the one at the upper right. Bond strength is directly related to bond order. However, the relationship is not perfectly linear, and this has important consequences on reactivity. For instance, because a double bond is not as stable as two single bonds, you might imagine that the process of addition to a double bond to form two new single bonds would be thermodynamically favorable. Addition to a triple bond is similarly thermodynamically favorable. Exchange of a pi bond for a sigma bond is also favorable, as this calculation shows. This comes about because the second bond of a double bond, whose energy is reflected in this energy difference, is not as stable as a sigma bond. The high exothermicity of the step on the next slide makes it very reasonable to propose as part of a reaction mechanism. And we've seen this step before. It's the electrocyclic ring closing of a 6-pi electron system. By summing up all of the bond energies in both molecules, as is done here, we can see why the closed product is more stable than the open starting material. This kind of bond energy analysis is very useful in determining which of two interchangeable molecules is the more stable, and thus which direction the reaction will run in. For instance, in this example, we don't have to look at all of the bonds in both molecules in order to determine which one is more stable than the other. All we really have to notice is that in this reaction, a pi bond is exchanged for a sigma bond. As a result, we can subtract the energy of a sigma bond from the energy of the second bond in a double bond in order to determine the favorability of this reaction. And it's not a coincidence that the difference in energy between these two numbers, negative 30, is the same as the energy difference between a sigma bond and the second bond of a double bond.